Scandinavia. I'm Bob here. Hi. In just a few seconds, I'm going to reveal what I think is the most special day or period during a NoFap journey. But before I do, I just want to say, well, one of the favorite things to talk about in the NoFap community seems to be the number of days and different periods during the journey. So, is there a specific magical day on NoFap? Well, of course there isn't, except for on day 7 when there's a temporary spike in testosterone in most men who abstain. NoFap doesn't really work like that. You know, that on this exact day, this will happen, and then on that day, this other thing will happen. No, it doesn't work like that, because we have all different brains, and on top of that, some are more or less addicted to stuff, and some guys are not even addicted at all. However, that said, there is indeed a period in the NoFap journey that I have personally felt is pretty special. No, I'm not talking about the day 7 testosterone spike here, but another period. And so, just to make it a bit more playful here, if someone twisted my arm and made me say a period I found to be the most special during my own journey, and let's say they really forced me to spit out an exact day, I would actually say, okay, day number 14. Now, why would I say day 14? Well, as I have been saying before, the first 2 weeks were the absolute hardest part for me. And this seems to be true for most guys out there. Once I got over 2 weeks, it started to get a bit easier not to fall for the cravings. And in addition to this, after 2 weeks, I also started to procrastinate less and started to feel a bit better about life in general. Another interesting thing about this is that studies on rats have found that it takes about 14 to 15 days of abstinence for the rats to fully upregulate their androgen receptors after they have been busting like crazy. And if you didn't know, androgen receptors are small receptors that testosterone itself binds to in order for you to be able to utilize it fully. Now, of course, this was an animal study, and it does not have to translate to humans at all. I'm fully aware of that. But what if it does? I mean, the time frame certainly seems interesting. And again, I'm far from being the only one noticing improvements after the 2 week mark. Here are a couple of quotes from other NoFappers out there. Guy number 1, quote, "Whenever I get to 14 days, I start feeling more secure in myself. I don't really care so much what people think of me after that," unquote. Guy number 2, quote, "It takes me about 2 weeks to start feeling the NoFap benefits. During the first week, I often have intense cravings, and in my second week, I often feel depressed, but by the time week 3 rolls around, I start feeling really, really good," unquote. Now, I also have to say that just because we play around with a certain day number in today's video, it doesn't mean that everything will suddenly be all sunshine and rainbows after 2 weeks clean for everyone out there. No. And that certainly wasn't the case for me either. The flatline and withdrawals can last way longer than that, along with depression and feeling a void, which was certainly the case for me. But I always felt that there was some kind of turning point happening right around the second week mark, and that things slowly, very, very slowly started getting better from there on out. But with a lot of ups and downs still from there, of course. So, if you're on day 14 on NoFap right now and you happen to be feeling really low, chances are a turning point is right around the corner for you. And by the way, did you know that if you're in a flatline, that doesn't mean that all of the NoFap benefits will be absent? You might still feel some of them to some extent. In fact, I've recently made a poll about benefits during a flatline, and I will share this with you in a video real soon, so consider subscribing for that. In the meantime, have you guys seen my video series on the NoFap attraction phenomenon? No? Well, if not, I think you might find it very interesting indeed. You can see part 1 on the screen right here. Just click on that and it'll take you there. This is Scandinavian Bob signing out for today. And remember, like Winston Churchill used to say, if you're going through hell, keep going.